So we're going to practice proper pelvic floor activations. Now, because this movement can be a little bit tricky to do properly, we're going to break it up into three steps. First, we just need to find the muscles, then we kind of need to learn how to coordinate them, and then we're going to learn how to coordinate that movement with our breath. Let's start simply by finding the pelvic floor muscles first, because the pelvic floor is actually a series of muscles that form the bottom of the core, and they have attachment points in the front, the back, and the sides. So let's start by finding the front of the pelvic floor muscles. And to do that, you're gonna sit in a chair, and I usually like to straddle the corner of a chair, so the corner of the chair is between your legs, and you relax and pretend as if you are peeing, right? And then you contract those muscles that you would use to stop the flow of urine. So you imagine as if you're trying to stop the flow of urine. That's the front of the pelvic floor. If you need a little extra help finding it, just lean forward in your chair a little bit more and try the contraction, and you can find the front. Now to find the back, pardon the analogy, but you're gonna imagine as if you're trying to stop yourself from passing gas. So you don't wanna squeeze your butt here. You wanna think more of the inside. So squeeze the muscles on the inside. And if you need a little help finding the muscles, just lean back a little bit more and do that contraction, and you can find the back a little bit better. So now we found the front and the back, we need to find the sides. To do that, you want to take your hands and sit on them. And you'll find those two little bony sits bones, right? That's where the sides of your pelvic floor attach. So now we found all the attachment points. Now, how do we coordinate them together? What you want to think of is bringing all four attachment points together and then up, and then fanning them all the way back down to their starting position. So I like to use a tissue analogy. So if you imagine you have a tissue spread out on a table and I picked that tissue up by the center, when I pull it up, all of the attachment points, ideally, come a little bit closer, right, together. And then when I put that tissue back down, I'm gonna fan it out to its starting position so all four attachment points go back out. So just try that a few times first. You're going to visualize yourself bringing all four points together, and then can you feel them pulling all the way up? And now relax and lower them all the way down. And try that one more time. Bring everything in, front to back, sides pull in, and now lift them all the way up, and then lower them all the way down. Now the last step in our three-step process here is we have to take that movement and coordinate it with our breath. So we go back and we combine this movement with the 360 breathing. So on my inhale, I'm going to relax my pelvic floor as the rib cage expands. Now on the exhale, that's when I'm going to bring all of those attachment points together and pull them all the way up. And now on the inhale, they go all the way back down and relax. So again, exhale, pelvic floor pulls up, all those attachment points come in and up, and on my inhale, everything relaxes and lengthens. And that movement right there, that slow coordination with the breath, is what we call pelvic floor activations slow, or PFAs slow, right? It's that coordinated lengthening and contraction with the breath. Now, we can also vary the tempo on that too in what we call PFAs fast. And that is simply the same action, so it's the lifting and lowering, but now we do it a little bit quicker tempo and we don't necessarily coordinate with breath, you just breathe comfortably. So the muscles are going lift and lower, lift and lower, lift and lower, lift and lower. So that's a PFA fast. So it's good to do a few of, actually both of those, the PFA slow and the PFA fast, because they actually work different muscle fibers. So maybe you do, you know, 3 to 5 of those PFA slow and then 8 to 10 of the faster ones, and that's a set. And maybe you practice a set or two a day. Now the thing you really want to make sure you're focusing in is on the lengthening portion. Most of us can do that contraction, right? We're always used to contracting, but it's actually the lengthening that is the more difficult piece, and that is what we, our muscles need to be able to do for delivery, right? Because the pelvic floor muscles have to be able to relax and lengthen delivery. At the same time, if we can't lengthen the muscles, that's like taking, you know, holding weights and doing a bicep curl like this, right? It's just not as effective. We need those muscles to know how to lengthen all the way down and contract all the way back up. So it's more about a full range of motion. And that's actually why we avoid the use of the term Kegel when we talk about pelvic floor work, because somehow Kegels have become synonymous with, first of all, just working the front of the pelvic floor. So we often hear them described as, think of stopping the flow of urine, which is, we just learned, just the front of the pelvic floor. The other thing is Kegels have kind of been synonymous with that just contraction phase. And now we know the important piece is to be able to work through that full range of motion. Yes, a contraction, but also a full lengthening. So that is pelvic floor activations. PFAs slow, coordinated with breath, and then PFAs fast, not coordinated with breath, just breathing comfortably.